Hello, everyone, and welcome to Davis, California, in the outskirts of Sacramento. We are here at Nugget Fields for the USAFL WRT Regional Tournament. 18-7 for the action. This is the second of three regional tournaments this season, the next one being in Racine, Wisconsin, in 2 weeks' time. But we are here alongside Dennis Ryan, the president of the USAFL. And Dennis, we have here four teams total that are in the top USAFL top 20. Should be, in fact, that's a very good women's team. It should be cracking the action.
Absolutely, Brian. No better game than this first one. Los Angeles Dragons versus the Orange County Bombers. Huge rivalry between these two teams. So it should really get kicked off in some great fashion.
And two very, very good teams. The Orange County Bombers ranked number one in the country. They are defending Division I runners-up against the LA Dragons, currently ranked number six in the country. They will most likely be in Division I next year. They have played as a Division I squad or Division I quality since their inception back in 2011. And they are here in their fifth full season of play. They are a very, very tenacious team, but both sides sporting very good talent, young, good American players, and some Aussie veterans as well. So we're going to play two 20-minute halves, at least for this first game. Temperature is not too bad. It's in the 70s here. It's supposed to warm up a little bit farther on.
There you go. And this is a massive unit in the ruck for the Los Angeles Dragons. He's a big boy.
He is a big boy. He knocks it out. We'll keep an eye on him. That's Donald Lee, number 26. As Orange County keeps it, there's a handball. They'll go back. Orange County and the white jumpers going from left to right. As he goes for the mark, he doesn't quite take it. The ball goes out of bounds. We have our first stoppage and a boundary throw. Just underway, Orange County in Los Angeles. LA is in the teal/gray orange jumpers as the boundary throw-in will be directly across from us. It comes spinning back in the play. It is tipped out by the big ruck for Orange County. And it looks like they've frozen it. We'll have a ball up as the umpire comes in. And that's Tom Mills, our chief umpire. And Lee, the ruckman, gets it out. Dollar in there for Los Angeles. It comes out to the near side. Number seven there for Orange County.
Scotty Leal, it was.
That is Scotty Leal, in fact. And they work it forward now. Good pickup. He's got to go back. Shimmies from one tackle. Shimmies away from the second. Had to get the handball away. Just barely does. And the Dragons pick it up, but it's turned over. Again, Leal is there, and that one is knocked down. Kicked over towards the sideline. And just finding the boundary line out of bounds. And chasing after that for Orange County was Timmy Ellis, number 50. Walking, spinning back in the play. Territorial advantage. It looks like they're going to redo it again. Territorial advantage so far favoring the Orange County Bombers. Ball comes spinning back in the play again. Controlled by Los Angeles. And being wrapped up there by the Dragons was number two. Go ahead, Dennis.
Looking very much like an AFL game at the moment. There is a lot of players around the ball at the moment. Some of these guys obviously trying to integrate some of the AFL coaching strategies.
That's a good thing. We're definitely trying to see that more and more in the USAFL. There's a shot for goal, and it looks like it's gone off there, and it's going through for one behind. So first score of the game goes to the Orange County Bombers. It's 1-0. Looking for Los Angeles. Out in the center of the ground. And a great mark there. There's that big run. Donald Lee. The Jason Holmes type character, Eric Wallace. They kick it out. Not the greatest of kicks. It's intercepted. And here comes Orange County up on that far side over there. And it squirts out. Going in to get it for Los Angeles was number 52. That's Frederick Schulman. And a lovely boundary throw.
Pretty tight boundary over there. It's pretty much right up against the fence. We had a little bit of difficulty fitting these two fields in here yesterday. It took us a while to figure it out.
You guys did a great job with these fields. Very, very nice. As I was out there earlier walking, the grounds are in pretty good shape considering the drought conditions recently. Yeah, as LA with the ball kicks it up on that far wing.
Good grab.
Good mark over there.
Who's that?
See how he gets around. It looks like it's David Dollar. No, it was David Dollar. And he'll kick it back into the middle. Taken there by for Los Angeles. Get up now to the near side. They go after it. Oh, good Shepherd there, but still getting to it. That's number 77 for LA. Oh, good knockdown. That's turns around. Weatherall. Brad Weatherall. Oh, good bump off. That's a great job of winning the ball.
And now kicks it up into the forward 50 for the first time for LA, but a good job of defense there. They pick it up. Now kicks it out straight into the middle of the ground and kicked directly across. And they paid the mark. Ball's kicked up on that far side. The mark taken over in that back pocket. Lockie Agares.
It's an intercept mark by LA. The Dragons starting to pinch a little bit. Taking a look around. Now he's going to kick that one up on the far side. Pack forming. Another defensive mark.
So a bit of aerial ping pong here in the early going. And now they'll run it out to the far side. Cuts into the middle of the ground.
Long kick inside 50. A big booming kick. Oh, nice mark. His number when he comes around. But good job by Orange County. And now they'll have a set shot for goal here. Now they're going to be just at the edge of the 50. Stuttering run up. Kick up on the way. And that also looks like it's going to be one run score. So 2-0. Orange County has had better of the offensive play so far, Dennis, but still just two behinds. Take it out to the near side. Lee up there again. He got his hand on it. Controlled by LA. And now that's number 2 for LA up to the near side. That is Paul Oakham again.
The ball gets kicked out. It'll bubble through out of bounds. We'll have a boundary throw in. 2-0. Orange County leads. Now 5 minutes or so into this opening term, again, 2:20 minutes out. Ball comes spinning back in the play. Lee again gets to it. It's knocked down. And it's I don't think he was going for a torp, but it was a torp. And it's picked up by Orange County. They spear it back into the middle. And he's going to be paid the mark. Good job there by number 28.
Yeah, they're going to bring it back and pay him the mark. We have 28 in here for Los Angeles.
Simon, the boys were calling, so.
Yeah.
Simon
Sweeney, that's what it is.
It looks like it's Simon Sweeney. Good mark. Oh, good job there again by Lokeem.
He's number 2 for the Dragons.
Yep, Paul Lokeem.
Oki, is it?
Lokeem, or Iokeem. Iokeem, it looks like. That's an I. Looks like an L from here.
Looks quite confident in his kicking ability here. He's about, it's actually about a 45-meter line there, so not a 50, so he's kicking right on that 45, so he's kicking from 50 out.
Oh, it's a good kick. It looks like it's headed left a little bit, and indeed it looks like it has gone for a minor score. 2-1.
Both teams on the board here. It's been it's a very evenly matched game. Both teams are trying to play a little bit of possession footy and have done well until about the third or fourth kick, and they seem to turn it over.
Yeah, we're seeing some good passages of play, but right there at the end, it seems like it's been a little shaky as they turn it back in, and the mark is taken defensively. Kick there for number 15, Paul Francis, who kicked it, but it was turned over. And now here comes Orange County with it the other way, looking for Aguera again, but the mark is taken defensively by number 77. As Jeffrey Robinson, one of the good young Americans, kicks with his left foot, which is his right one. Good job. Here's 56 with a left-footed kick. It bananas away. It's headed towards the boundary line. Will they keep it in play? No, they can't, as Anthony Martin was the person who kicked it, swung around, kicked it onto his left boot, and the English of it sort of carried it towards the boundary line. But again, advantageous for Los Angeles as the ball comes back in the play in their forward pocket. Lee with a head out to Martin. He kicks for goal, and he's got it.
That is a superb bit of play from Lee there. That is just a magnificent tap to his rover, who was unmanned, standing on the defensive side of the pack, which is pretty common in a forward pocket sort of area. A lot of defenders seem to stack up on the defensive or their defensive side of the throw-in, which often leaves the other side exposed. And great little tap over there. There's probably five or six players on one side of the ball there and the one dragon on the other side. And just a fantastic tap by Lee there, straight down his throat. And a fantastic snap to finish it off.
That's good footy sense right there. And again, Lee just gets the head out. Orange County controls it. We'll talk about Lee in just a moment in comparison to some of the players that we're seeing now cross over into the USA and to the AFL. And we have a ball up in the middle of it. Compare guys like Eric Wallace or Jason Holmes who use their side, but it takes good footy skills to be able to do to fall off a shot like that.
Another good tap. To keep an eye on a number of his hitouts. Meanwhile, they kick it to the near side. Oh, good job to sort of keep it away from his defender. Musto is in there, and it looks like he's going to get called for holding the ball. They're going to play on. Oh, good smother there by number 32 for Orange County. And now they want a call. They want a ball call, and they're just going to say, give it to me. 15 again was Paul Francis. 32 for Orange County with the smother. We don't have. Maybe it was 37. It was Joel Hobson. And now it's going to be a free kick. A lot of yelling here in the early going. We say this is a rivalry match. It is. These teams. Oh, good. Oh, good job. Almost by Lockie Aguirre.
He is taken down without the ball. Play on, says the umpire.
Iokim now. And the ball is in a good block out of bounds. That was 22 for Orange County who got in there. That was Gareth Allen, who was able to get into the face of Tim McDougal, number 39 for Los Angeles. Nearing the halfway point opening term, it's 7-2. As the ball comes into play,
it's a very, it was kind of an awkward throw-in, and it's picked up by Orange County. The kick is high and deep, backforming up on the far side. Good defensive spoil there by number 9 for Los Angeles. They get it off to 17 for Orange County. Here's the kick. Oh, as they play on, almost had it. There's a shot for goal, and it rolls through, and it's another minor score. 7-3 now the score. Three behind for Orange County to 1-1-7. The pace is picking up a little bit more, Dennis, here as we pass the midway point of this opening half.
Yeah, it was certainly scrappy for those first 3 or 4 minutes, and then now the game is starting to open up and be a bit more free-flowing, which is obviously the type of footy we'd like to see.
Yes. The ball comes kicked in out on that far side.
Lee again.
Oh, Lee is over there. He is all over the place here in the early going. And it looks like there is a, it's going to be a free kick.
Yeah, he's paid the mark.
Yeah, he's paid the mark. Adjusting my binoculars as he hands the ball off.
Oh, he's lent the old Ruckman rules. Handball always.
Yep.
Don't kick it.
Don't kick it. There's the handball. The mark is, it's intercepted rather. They turn. It's a line drive kick. Lee's going to kick it up eventually. Goes forward. He shrugs off one tackle. He is so strong. Handballs it up into the middle. Taken down there by number 44 in County. That is Scott Ragosh. He's knocked free. That was almost holding off the ball by Seth Aguero.
It
looks like it's going to be a free kick. And they kick it out to the near side. For Iokum. Paul Iokum with the mark. He's going to turn around. Handball it directly across, looking for Robinson.
Robinson just gets it off. It's intercepted. Oh, good smother by Iokum, who's been all over the place also.
Left-footed kick for Orange County. Oh, almost taking the mark. And now picking it up. It looks like that is a wheel there. Oh, good tackle there by Iokum. Handball's across the 25 for Los Angeles. That is Thomas Grigg into the middle now. Lee is taken down. That has to be ball, and it is. And play on as Orange County will play it on into the middle of the ground.
Number four there for Orange County has been getting plenty of the footy with the long flowing hair.
Jake Snow from Orange County.
Oh, he's obviously a snowy.
Oh, yes. You would think that would counteract the hot weather that we had here. Meanwhile, it's a free kick for Orange County.
Yeah. Speak of the devil.
Speak of the devil, it is Jakey Snow. So Snow's going to line up. Probably about 45 meters out or so.
Well, he's probably kicking from about 52.
We'll call it 52 and a half. Kick is up on the way. It looks like it's going to die. And that one is hit out into the behind post. It'll be a boundary throw-in. Good defensive play by LA to keep any further damage, but they're going to have to back down the hatches here with the boundary throw in that corner. Welcome spinning back at the play. Controlled by Orange County. Again, they go down. Up on that far side. Good pick up by LA. A whistle. And they got another. Looks like it's going to be a free kick. They've given the ball to number 10. That's Adrian Heffernan, one of the veterans of this Orange County squad. With a major kick here, a major score, he can give his team the lead. It'll be their first of the day. Slow, steady run up for Heffernan. Kick is up on the way. It looks good from here, and it is. Heffernan puts the Bombers in front. Orange County 139, LA 117. We played a little more than
15 minutes of this opening turn.
So Orange County seems to have got a little bit more of the possessional territorial advantage here, but for the most part, it's pretty even.
Yeah, it certainly is a very even game. And reflected so on the scoreboard, both about, what is it, 1-2 to 1-1 at the moment?
1-3 to 1-1.
1-3 to 1-1. And, yeah, they both seem to be moving the ball very similarly.
Lee again.
He's just a massive unit. Now, he's the second big African-American, and I'm making that assumption that he's African-American, ruckman that the Dragons have had. In the last few years, they had another really tall guy, and his name escapes me at the moment. He was up in his 30s, so he's probably possibly retired now. But he was another big boy that came to the game late. So certainly, they've got some sort of feeder system going at the moment. The Dragons, it seems to be providing them with some very big, tall ruckman.
Ellis, or rather, that's a Ragosh number 40. They turn around, number 21. He's tapped, just gets it over, and he's taken down as well. They'll have a ball up, or they pay that well. They say it is ball. And it is number 4. That is Matthew Hitch. I believe he's the brother of Ryan Hitch. Matthew Hitch, number 4. And Ryan Hitch is the president of the club. It looks like he's going to take the kick here. Or they say they're calling blood rule. Number 21 is Marcos Kivarchik. Orange County. As it forms and the mark is taken there, again, that's Snowy. Into the middle of the ground. Looking for Leal number 2. Scotty Leal goes out to the far side. And Marcus Tower, it's taken by the one hit. They give it over to the number 17 there. That is Michael Taylor. Taylor almost took it. He had to get off the man there. And it looks like they paid him the free kick in contact. It looks like it was high tackle, high contact. So, Orange County.
Is this Heff again? Yes, it is.
It is, in fact, happening again. Gave his team the lead a little bit earlier, just a couple of minutes ago, with that kick from out. Looks like it's about the same type of angle, except over on this side in front of Tent City here at Davis. I don't think he was close enough to be open mark. I think that's fine.
He's actually making his angle worse there, Heff.
Yeah, oh, that's going to go through. We had a great view of that one.
Yep.
Dead center, perfect. So Heffernan in second, Orange County second. That takes them to 2-3-15. LA 1-1-7. Just under, just about 2.5 minutes to go here in the first half. Very entertaining game. These two teams met a week ago, and Orange County came out winners. 49-48 was the final score.
That must have been a great game.
It was a fantastic game from all accounts. Ball back in the center, and Donald Lee again gets in there. But again, Orange County's able to control it. Did he tackle? No, he got him. Good tackle there. It was a bit of a backdoor tackle, but they got it. And now a free kick by number 26 for Los Angeles. Goes, and the mark is taken. Oh, I think he was off.
Oh, okay. It's going to be LA's free kick here.
No, he paid the mark. He didn't pay the mark.
He didn't come off. He didn't come off. He shimmied a little bit.
He did. I think he thought about it, but I think that's a correct decision. I don't think he did enough to go over the mark.
What's the rule on that, just for folks who may not be familiar with it? Like, I know once you make some sort of move to play on, but it looked like he started to do that.
So you have to either go over the mark where you actually took the ball and caught the ball, which is why it's called a mark. It's like an imaginary mark is made on the ground.
And the goal there, that was a great kick. number 22 for Los Angeles, that is Darren Olsen. And Olsen has cut the margin again. So, with 1 minute to go here in the first half, the score, LA goes to 2-1-13. Orange County, 2-3-15. The margin back down to 2 points.
So, getting back to the mark situation there, you've got to either go over the spot where you took the mark, or you need to come off your line. So, I don't think in either of those situations he'd gone over his mark, or he'd moved far enough off his line to warrant a play on call.
Under a minute to go, Wheel with the handball, looks for Snow. Snow with his left foot, kicks that one above. Oh, and a good mark taken out on that far side again. Okay. Heffernan turns and fires. The kick is up high. He kicks it for goal, but it has gone off to the side. It's another behind. With 20 seconds to go, the margin's back to 3. It's 16-13, Orange County. You don't say that unofficially, of course, at the time here. Ball kicked up on that far side. Pack Worms again, almost claimed control. Left-footed kick, and that is halftime. So a very entertaining first 20 minutes of football here at Nugget Fields in Davis, California, as the Orange County Bombers, currently ranked number one in the nation, holding off a very, very good Los Angeles Dragons team by 3 points. Score at halftime is the Orange County Bombers, 2-4, 16 points. The LA Dragons, 2-13. We'll be back in the second half action of this one. You're watching the USAFL Western Regional Tournament here on USAFL.com. Second half action about to get underway here with the LA Dragons trailing the Orange County Bombers by 3 points. And this time Lee does not get first to the ball here. It's knocked forward by Orange County. LA has it. They have a couple of guys on the ball. That was Matthew Hitch in there for Los Angeles. And Lee again in there all by himself, but they can't control it. Orange County has it. Oh, tackled him. Again did Hitch. He wants a free kick. He's not going to get it. No prior opportunity. As 17 for Orange County. That was Michael Taylor. Had it, lost it, and another ball up. And again, Lee gets his hand on it. I'll tell you what, the ruckman there, number 29, or rather 39, is Ryan Larsorti, having a rough day, and he's going to have a rough day some more, as that one is kicked into the square. Almost took the mark. It's knocked down, and now it's a dog pile. Stacks on the mill, throw a blanket over 10 players, and Millsy, the umpire, will come in. Got to switch from soccer mode to footy mode. Oh, good job there by the ruckman, who's able to come in. It's controlled and then kicked. They went out on the full, and they're going to get it. Oh, Scott Leal over there. That was Heffernan.
Number 40 it was. He's got the Scotty Leal hairstyle, though.
That's Scott Ragosh. They're going to call illegal Shepherd.
And Snow gets the free kick.
Good job. Good job to draw the free kick there. So here is Snow. He's going to go in short. Couldn't get to it. And it's picked up there. 62 for LA, and now they control it. It's up high, tapped out towards the sideline. It's going to find it and go out of bounds as Anthony Martin, number 56, was closest to the ball. Just underway in the second half. 16-13, Orange County the lead as the ball comes spinning back into play. 29 in there for Orange County. That's Adam Shanks. Shanks is the ruckman, by the way. We called him incorrectly before. My apologies. As they come over.
His name's Shanks, not Lee?
For Orange County, 29.
Oh, okay,
I called him something else as the ball gets kicked and then we'll go out of bounds.
ball comes spinning back in the play here, directly across from us. Lee again. Oh, good job with the left hand. But again, you know, he's winning these hitouts, but he's not getting a lot of support all the time. He's tackled. They want ball. They're going to get a ball up instead. Ball's going to be just on the outer part of the square. So that'll be one thing I think the Dragons will have to look forward to. They have this big, good ruckman.
Great handball.
Great handball there. And they're going to whistle it, and they're going to call it a throw. Well, it wasn't such a good handball, I guess. I guess that's how good it was, is that it was a throw.
Mills is right there, so.
Iokan kicks it just through the hands, and it's picked up by 32 for Orange County. And now up on that far side, Lee had it. They squirt it through, and the umpire will come in and have another ball up. Lee helping his opposite number there up. Good to see. And again, knocked forward, but this time he has support. Free kick. What did you see in there, Dennis? It was an infraction in the ball.
It was off the ball, off the ruckman. It looks like a young Dollar here, the Rover's got the free kick.
Yep. Goes out to the far side. Oh, good spoil. And kept over there. And again, it just squirts out. And then a good kick over there by Orange County, but or at least to get it away. They're going to run over there and challenge it. That's a 26 over there. It squirts out over there. Jeffrey Robinson in for Los Angeles, number 77. Play on, says the umpire. Rogosh kicks it up high. Almost a one-handed mark taken over there by Lockie Aguirre's. Aguirre's has it. And two Dragons jump on him. We'll have a ball up. This is a scoreless second half, still 16-13 in favor of Orange County. That may change in a second. It's kicked for goal. That is a magnificent kick. And Orange County extends their lead. Great job to get it off of one step. And that takes Orange County to 3-4-22. LA 2-1-13. And that's out of the stoppages. Very, very important to win a ball. And that's what we said before. It's good, you know, it's good to have good ruck work, but you have to have good on ballers to accentuate that.
Well, it's pretty much a payback. You know, it's for the Dragons' goal in the first quarter, but they've got the same way on the first half. So
yep.
Lee's got a free kick here.
Yep. Now I think he's actually going to kick this one, in light of what we said before about ruck work. He's got all sorts of people yelling for him. Hitch goes for it, and not cleanly. He's tackled, dispossessed. He's tackled, dispossessed, up on that far side over there. And it looks like a free kick. And again, this is gonna be Iokan. So Iokan's gonna go back. This is about, we'll say about 53 meters out. From dead in front. The kick is up on the way. Looks like it might have the legs. It does! What a great kick.
It was touched right on the line.
But it was touched on the line. Oh, a fingernail maybe. Everyone got really excited. I got really excited. But it takes LA over to 2-2-14. They trail Orange County by 8 points. Out to the near side. Lee goes up for it. Can't claim it. Dollar with it. The Rover. He kicks that one inside 50. Knocked down by LA. Picked up again by Hitch. Hitch is claiming. They call for ball. And they got it. Or no far opportunity. Call by Millsy.
David.
About 7 minutes going in the second half, 13 to go. LA claims, and rather Orange County claims, and pushed off the ball. The ball goes out of bounds. Looks like it's over and out, and it is. The pace has not relented since that first half, Dennis. Still very, very good pace. Ball keeps spinning back in the play. And now it's like Sebastian Aguirre. Martin for Los Angeles can't control it. Rogosh able to get into it. Robinson for LA. kicks it towards Hitch. Hitch comes out to the near side. He can't get a clean handball off. It pinballs around. Iokun can't get a hand on it. There's a handball. There he is.
Right handball, yeah.
Kicks that one in. Oh, that's coming back. Anamark is taken defensively there by the fullback on the last line of defense for Orange County. Paul Okim has been all over the place. Kicks it out to the far side.
Leal.
And it's taken by Leal in the back pocket.
Doesn't have any options as he's searching for...
Not forthcoming. He's looking around. Orange County's got to do a better job to the Bombers. Goes up to take it. It's knocked down. Controlled. And it's over and out of bounds.
And he played a free kick for holding the ball. He lost the ball on the tackle.
He did. It's kicked up. They say play on. Ball's on the turf. Orange County's got it back. That one kicked up on the far side.
And
oh,
snow.
Good mark. And again, that looks like snow.
Yep.
Snow kicks it out into the center of the
down
park.
The runner.
Looking, and the mark is taken by 42 for Orange County. That is Kenneth Reyes. Reyes out to the near side, looking for Aguera. And the mark is taken by Lucky Aguirre's. And that was a great passage of play as Orange County shows their class.
That was a fantastic passage of play.
And Sebastian Aguirre, the veteran, finding Lucky Aguirre's, the big tall unit. We saw him more of an offensive role at Nationals last year. The kick is up on the way here, and he shows that he can do it very well on the offensive side as he kicks Orange County's fourth goal of the game. So Orange County goes to 4-4-28, LA 2-2-14. The margin is 14 points with about 10 and a half minutes to go. Orange County in control here. The game's not over yet, but Orange County seems to have their hand on the joystick right now. Or I guess on the thruster thing.
Yeah. Certainly, the Dragons have got some work to do now to snatch this game.
Great hit out by Lee, but again, Snow. We'll have a bounce, have a second bounce. He controls it. Now he looks. Left-footed kick inside 50. Again, Agarz goes up. Can't take the mark. Good effort as he stays with it. He's pushed down. No call. Play on, says the umpire. LA has it. They throw a blanket over about 10 players, and they'll give it the ball. They'll give it a ball up. Orange County looking for the knockout blow. Again, Lee knocks it forward, but he knocks it forward to the Ruckman for Orange County. He's held up. No prior up. No. It's going to be a free kick to LA. Iokim up the far side. And the mark is taken. He's going to play that into the middle. He'll kick again, looking for Martin. Martin falls down. Ball hits the ground. And again, it comes free. They push it forward. The ball is pushing forward for LA, but we have a tackle. We have a free kick here. It looks like pushing the back. So here now is LA to try and cut into this 14-point lead. And it is Anthony Martin. The kick will come from about 35 meters out at about a 40-degree angle. Well, they're now moving him over. So we'll call it about a 45-degree angle. Martin, kick up on the way. That's coming back. Did it hook? No, it's good for a goal. It hooked, but right after it crossed through the goalposts.
That makes it a bit interesting.
It does. I mean, there's still plenty of time. LA goes to 3-2-20.
I don't know how much time we have left, Brian.
Looks like 8.5 minutes, Dennis.
No, there's certainly enough time. So 8 points of difference?
Yep, that's two kicks.
Yep.
So here we go, ball back in the center. Nobody got a clean handle on it this time. They come out to the near side. And a whistle, and a ball up. Reyes, number 42 in there for Orange County. And Lee again, but this time it looks like a 22 for Orange County had it. Long handball, not effective. And a whistle and a high tackle. They're going to bring that back. Looks like the high tackle there was on number 12 for Orange County, David Lazeke. Oh, it will be paid to, it's paid to Lazeke. He gives it to Snow.
That was a right foot kick by Snow. And he's obviously very adept on both sides.
His right foot, which is his wrong foot. But now LA has it. They kick it out into the center of the ground.
running with these guys?
Going forward, can't control cleanly. Lee in there, out the back. The ball is tipped, play on it. It hits the ground anyway. Iokum gets to it. Doesn't get a clean handball off. Picked out. Again, Martin to Hitch. Back to Iokum now from the pocket. He kicks it out, centering ball. Lee in there for Los Angeles. He controls it. Had it, lost it. He's wrapped up. And they say he's tackled. A great tackle there. If you're not familiar with the game, even though he didn't actually get physically tackled, he got held up, but you do have to dispose of the ball in a reasonable amount of time. He didn't do it there, so Orange County has it. Leo out on the far side. And the kick from that back pocket, up into the wing position on that far side. And the mark is taken, but it looks like they're going to give a free kick. And it's Lockie Aguirre's, who's roving back in towards that wing position, up on that far side, and a good mark is taken. It's kicked, and he finds Heffernan up on that right side. So Heffernan's played both sides of the ball, but he stayed on that fat side over there.
They moved the ball really well again there, Orange County.
They are, and as we move towards 6 minutes to go in the game, a goal here may just give them a little bit of comfort. Kick is up on the way. It looked like it drifted across the face. Was it touched before it went out? No, out on the full. So LA dodges a bullet. They have 6 minutes to get 8 points. Up to the far side. Oh, uncontested intercept mark by 22. That's Gareth Allen. Allen looking into the middle. It's taken there by 17 with his left foot. That's a great kick. Was it touched? No, that's a goal. A great kick by Michael Taylor. Steadied that one off of 1 foot. And a great kick by the Bombers. And that gives them a very comfortable 14-point lead. Still plenty of time, but you would think the way the Bombers have been controlling things, they may have
one finger on this game. The score is 5-4-34 RGM. To the Dragons, 3-2-20, 5 minutes to play.
Snow running down to the halfback flank there, so going to the centre halfback position to shore things up and protect Orange County's lead.
An infraction there. It looks like they had 5 men in the square. Orange County, as Jonathan Mills, the umpire over there, made the call. We found Hitch. Hitch kicks, bombs it inside 50. Ball goes to ground, stacks on the mill. Dogpile on the rabbit. And a free kick. That's gonna be a free kick. It looks like he had pointed in the way of Orange County, but the way everyone's moving, it looks like it's gonna be a free kick to LA. So here's the kick. Kick is up on the way. That's a very good kick, but yep, it is a behind. Darren Olson, number 22. It's still two kicks. LA, actually it's three kicks, 3-3-21 to 34 for Orange County. Oh, great mark by Martin, who just stuck his hands up over the pack. Now he's got to find the lead. Looking for a man up on that pocket, but he overcooked the kick. In fact, it may have even gone out on the full, but either way, it was caught by somebody by the back pocket, rather, for Orange County. Now they come up in the lead position. Big pack forms. And again, Martin out of the back. Couldn't take it cleanly. And out of all of that, almost went out of bounds right in front of Orange County.
Let's go, Bombers!
County leads by 13 points. Lee couldn't get a hand on it. Hitch can, picks that one up, and a mark is taken. And here comes Leal again, looking for a Gares, but it finds the boundary line instead. Boundary throw, and as the time ebbs away, the first game, this 14 Division I at the Western Regional, we have two men's divisions and a women's division. There's a Sacramento and Seattle taking place in the field to our left. We'll get you an update on that game in just a minute. Meanwhile, that one not handled cleanly. He came in for the tackle, did number 62 for Los Angeles.
and he's going to go back. He just picked that up, like he just lifted the ball off the ground just to get a kick. LA controls it up on that far side. They still have it over there. And everyone's down, and that one will be squirtled out over the line. Not much time to go in this one. I'll tell you what, in spite of the score line, LA has played very tough. I think this they've come exactly as we expected them to. They've played very hard. They fought for every ball. But Orange County's just been had the more scoring opportunities and made more of them. They look out up on that pocket, but it finds the boundary line instead. And we'll have a boundary throw-in. Not much time to go in this one. Coming up next, we'll have the Hong Kong Dragons taking on the Golden Gate Roos here on this field. We got our first look at our visitors from AFL South China. And as I said before, we have Division II action with the Sacramento Suns, Seattle Grizzlies, and the Portland Steelheads. And women's action featuring the Arizona Hawks, the Portland Sockeyes, the Sacramento Lady Suns, and the San Francisco Iron Maidens. This is LA trying to make the score line a little bit closer up on that far sideline. And coming out with the ball is Orange County. It looked like he had it, but the umpire will call him back. As we come up to 1 minute. Kicked up on that far side. Pitch in there, but it's tapped down to the Bombers. They control it now. And here comes Orange County, left foot kick high. And the mark is taken by Aguirre's. He's about two kicks from goal. Aguirre's bootlegs around. Kicks that one inside 50. That may actually carry, but it's kept off the line and touched. I'll tell you what, that's what made Lockie Aguirre's very dangerous as a fullback in Nationals for the in Orange County's grand final run last year was Aguirre's kickouts out of the back. So 35-21, 14 points the difference. Lee gets his hand on it. Taken down, oh, good tackle. And he gave him, and he's gonna call it there. Great tackle by 52 for Los Angeles, Frederick Schleen. And that will do it. The final whistle goes. A very, very good game here and a great opening between two teams ranked in the top six in the USAFL rankings. As the Orange County Bombers come out victorious, the final score lines. Orange County 5-5-35, LA 3-3-21. Very good game to start us off, Dennis. Your thoughts?
No, it was a very high-standard game. Actually, I was very impressed. Started off very scrappy, but then certainly the skills picked up and we started to see some flow and movement of the ball with two or three handballs and kicks. Generally, it would break down on the fourth or fifth one where they would turn it over, but certainly from a standard point of view, that you know, we're starting to get there to where we want to be, where we want to have a good high standard and quality of football. And certainly some of the new players that were out there have helped to raise that standard. That is it John Snow? Was his first name? Snow?
Snow, yeah.
I thought was probably the best player
Jake
out
Snow.
There. Jake Snow. I thought he was probably the best player out there on the ground. And certainly marked and disposed of the ball really, really well. He's very clean by foot, both sides of his body. And maybe it might pay for us to get out there and have a little chat to him.
Yeah, totally do that. Hey, Jake Snow knows more than John Snow, as it turns out.
Okay.
So that's it, our first game in the books. In the final score, Orange County Bombers 35, the Los Angeles Dragons 21. We'll be back for the second game as the Hong Kong Dragons take on the Golden Gate Roos. We'll have that for you next. Watching USAFL Western Regional Tournament here on USAFL.com.